Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn AE tips, tricks, and shortcuts in less than 7 minutes. No BS, just AE. This week I'll be showing you how to create shapes from vector layers. This is extremely helpful if you tend to use vector images on a regular basis for projects like infographics, explainer videos, and training videos. This is one of those very powerful yet little known tools in After Effects, and there are a ton. As always, these shape layers can be saved as presets, which will save you a ton of time with future projects. Okay, so off the bat, you can always save a vector image as a shape layer and save that shape layer as a preset. Okay, so say you want to animate this trophy here. Okay, now normally what you would have to do, to File, Import, here's our trophy image, bring it in here. Now this also may require some Illustrator work to get rid of the background, maybe the shadow, whatever. So instead of doing that, I've already saved this image as a shape layer. So watch, just go New, Shape Layer. Grab our trophy, bring it in, there it is. If you can grab these vector images and save it as a shape layer, you can automatically drag it in. So this saves a ton of time. Now, I got this idea from a client. I made this little hospital using shape layers, mainly rectangles, fills, and strokes. And she wanted the medical symbol right up here. So I found the vector image and I brought it in. And then I got to thinking, well, what if I want to use this again and not have to bring in that image, but rather just have it as a preset? So that's what I did. And this is the final result. So now every time I bring in this hospital, this symbol comes with it. And this is a vector image. So I'm going to show you how to do that real quick. Okay, so here is our EPS file. Let's bring that in. And let's hide this shape layer right now and just focus on our vector image. Now, the way that you get this to be a shape layer is you want to go to Layer, Create Shapes from Vector Layer. It's going to create a different group within one shape layer for every element of that design. This is a pretty simple design, so there may be about 10 to 15 different groups, but you see how this could get cumbersome, say if the image has shadows or a bunch of different layers. So you want to hit Create Shapes from Vector Layer. Okay, now the first thing you see After Effects does is it hides your EPS file. So the only thing that we're seeing right now is the actual shape layer version of that EPS. And you can actually even delete that. So as you can see in your contents, a different group was created for every element of this shape layer. Now, if you want to save this the way I did, what you want to do is you want to grab all the groups, go to Animation, Save Animation Preset, and as always, we come to our generic user preset folder, which is in Documents, Adobe, whatever version you're using, and User Presets. So I'm going to go into Vector Shape Layers, and we're going to save this as Caduceus. So hit Save, and see, we can go over here, we can do a quick search, and we see that it is, in fact, in our Vector Shape Layers. To see exactly where it is, go into our user presets, vector shape layers. There it is. Okay, so now how do we get this on to this hospital and save this whole thing as one preset? First, you want to go into your shape layer and let's go ahead and add a group, bring it to the very top, and let's name this Caduceus. So let's go back into our shape layer of the Caduceus, grab all of these groups, Control C, go back down to our new shape layer into the group that we called Caduceus, Control V, and there we have it. So now we can get rid of the shape layer version of the EPS so that all we have is our hospital with this shape. Within this, so you have transform properties for every one of these groups. So for Caduceus, all we have to do is move it up where we want. Hit Y for your pan behind tool. If you want to anchor that, make this smaller. Now, if we want this to be the same color as, say, our roof, with this group highlighted, go up to our fill. Let's grab the eyedropper and click on the roof. And there we are. Now, how do we save this whole thing as a preset? Once again, we want to highlight everything here. Animation, save animation preset. I've mentioned this before, but see our folder structure here is represented in our After Effects project. So let's go into vector shape layers. And we'll call this hospital. Once that saves, let's get rid of our contents. Do a quick search in our vector shape layers for hospital. Drag that in, and there you go. This hospital also contains the image of this Caduceus. So in this case, this was a very simple way to add an element to a shape layer that you already have. and there weren't that many groups, so it wasn't that difficult to deal with. However, there are cases where you may have a lot of groups, sometimes even over several hundred groups. That's where it can get kind of cumbersome. Now, if you're just looking to make an animation preset of a vector image without animating each individual element of that shape layer, then it's not that big of a deal. However, say you want to make this image into a shape layer. Okay, so I brought this EPS of this house image in right here. Now watch what happens if we go to layer, create shapes from vector layer. So what it's going to do is it's going to create a different group within one shape layer of every element within this. Now, the problem is, as you can see, when you open up the contents, you have hundreds of groups. You have 311 groups, which represent this one image. Again, if you're not looking to animate this house in any way, then that's not that big of a deal. You could actually just grab everything, all these groups, go to animation, save animation preset, and pop it right in there. And again, this will save you time from having to go to file, import file, trying to search through your directories to find out where it is and bring it in. So it does save you a ton of time, but say you did want to animate this. So like this, and I've gone through and I've taken the time to group all these elements together. You want to create a different group for each element. So what I did was, there are 11 windows. So I just went 1 through 11 and I grabbed the shapes that go to that and put them in the corresponding group here. I separated the bush left, bush right, the ledge, the door. You get the idea. And then within each one of these, they all have their own transform properties. So you can scale, move the position. You can do all that kind of stuff. So now this took some work because I had to go through and separate each element and put it into its own group. If you don't want to animate this, you don't have to worry about it. You can just grab this and put it in a group, highlight everything, and save it as an animation preset. Creating shapes from vector layers is yet another very powerful tool within After Effects. Even if you don't tend to animate vector images on a regular basis, every designer should have at least a basic understanding of how this works. This is a new channel and I'd love to do a lot more of these, so please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything that you'd like to see. Thanks everybody, and I'll see you next time.